Everybody, I want to talk about the number one injury in golf, and that's lower back pain. First, let's talk about why the lower back gets injured most. First of all, I always say your joints are either mobile or stable. Let me explain that real quick. In your body, every joint in your body should be able to move in three motions or in three planes, like your wrist can flex and extend, it should be able to rotate, and it should be able to hinge up and down. Every joint can move in three planes. Your shoulder can move in three planes, your hip can move in three planes, but some joints don't like to move in three planes. Like the knuckle on your finger. It likes to flex and extend. It can go sideways, it can rotate, but I really don't want you to do that. That would be a dislocation, right? So there are certain joints that like to move in one plane and certain joints that like to move in all three. Guess what? Your lower back likes to move in one plane. The joints in your lower back look like this. They're called facets. They're great at flexing and extending, bending forward, bending backwards. They are horrible at rotating and side bending. So think about this in the golf swing. We're bent over, right? We want to rotate and turn. When you rotate and turn, well, what's supposed to rotate? Believe it or not, it's supposed to be your upper back, your thoracic spine, and your hip. So you're supposed to rotate from your hip and your thoracic spine, but what if you're like most people out there? You don't have hip mobility, or you don't have spine mobility. Guess what you try and use? You try and rotate with your lower back. And that's the number one reason why the lower back goes down, is you don't have the mobility in your hip, you don't have the mobility in your spine, so you try and rotate from your lower back. Now, let me show you how to identify if that's you. Because if your back hurts, you got to know what the problem is. And if it's because you're trying to rotate from your lower back, you need to know this right away. The number one sign is called the reverse spine angle. Let me explain. Okay, if I rotate from my hip, I'm going to turn from my right hip. If I rotate from my spine, I turn from my spine, I bring my hands up here. If you were to look at my head compared to my pelvis, my head is farther away from the target than my pelvis. Right? So as I turn, my head is more to the right than my lower body to the target. People who try and rotate from their lower back, because the hip doesn't turn, the spine doesn't turn, they torque from their lower back. When they get to the top of the backswing, now their head is closer to the target than their pelvis. So they're leaning this way, where the normal person's leaning this way. So in your swing, just take your iPhone out, take your camera, videotape yourself from the front. If you get to the top of your swing and you are leaning towards the target, okay, those are big alarm bells going off here at TPI. That's called the reverse spine angle, and I always say it's not if, it's when you're gonna get lower back pain. You can still hit a good golf ball from there. There's some great players in history that have played from reverse spine angle, but they also have some of the worst backs in golf. So here's the key, surviving the golf swing. How do I not hurt my lower back? Use hip mobility, use spine mobility. Don't try and rotate from your lumbar spine. How do I know if you're doing that? It's the dreaded reverse spine angle. I hope that helps you lower your lower back pain and play better golf.